Okay, now let us talk about the dark field microscope. Unlike the bright field microscopy, which is very, very common in nature, what we can see in bright field microscopy, the basic system is that we have a light source, and after the light source we have condenser lens, which condenses the beam of light into a particular point, a particular focal point where our specimen resides, and this is a slide containing that specimen where the focused beam will be adjusted, and upper than the specimen or over the specimen what we have is the objective lens, which will collect the rays, diffracted rays, as well as the surrounding rays which is coming from this specimen or from this light throughout this light source. Okay, and finally after this objective lens we have a tunnel, and then we have the eyepiece lens to magnify the image which is provided by the objective. Furthermore, finally we can see. So this is the basic design of a light microscope, a bright field light microscope. So what do we mean by a bright field microscopy is normally what happens when you have a light source and a condenser. The condenser is free, and the only objective for condenser is to condense light into a particular focal point where you put the specimen, and we can see the specimen only because of the light passes through the specimen. So for this purpose we need our specimen to be very, very transparent. If our specimen is transparent, what happens when light travels through the specimen, some of those lights are deviated, and we can by seeing those deviation of the light we can know in which place of the specimen what type of things reside. Normally if we look at a cell, then we can determine whether the nucleus present, because we can find the nucleus is little bit condenser, then you can find a nucleus, we can see a nucleus in other region rather than the cytoplasm, which is much more transparent. So that's how bright field microscopy works. Now what is a dark field microscopy? A dark field microscopy is simply a light microscope. A bright field microscope, we can modify a bright field microscope to make this dark field microscope. So in this dark field microscope, the only difference is to attach a filter or a filter in this condenser lens. So what happens if we look at this picture, so you think about this is a condenser. So the only difference for dark field microscope, we plate a filter here, a filter which will block, not actually a filter, it's a blocker or stopper, a light stopper. So a disc like structure which will stop the light which is coming directly in this direction. So only it will allow the lights to be passed from this surrounding regions, from this terminal region to pass through. And this light from the terminal region will go and illuminate the specimen. So normally in this picture, both of the drawings for light bright field microscopy as well as dark field microscopy has been illustrated. In bright field microscopy, this arrows which are denoted here in black color, this is a light source for a bright field microscopy. So we can a huge amount of light passes through the specimen, we can see the specimen. That's why in bright field microscopy we need to stain our specimen to observe it in much more contrast. Now in dark field microscopy we will eliminate all these black arrow things, all these beams which is denoted with black arrow will not present in case of dark field microscopy. Only this ash color colored beams will enter into the system. So what happens when you present a slide without a specimen in dark field microscopy, then this light will passes through this region. So we can see these are the light beams from this terminal regions which are coming, and it will passes through this slide without specimen, and after they passes through, no light is gathered by this objective. So this so after this diffraction, we can see after this refraction, all the lights which are really minimized light are passing by through this outer side. So no light beam enter into this objective lens. Objective is incapable to gather light source. So the result, we'll see a very dark background, nothing in it. So it's a dark background, completely dark. Now what happens when you place a specimen here? when you place a specimen in the slide, this beam comes through the specimen. It will passes through the specimen. As it passes through the specimen, according to the presence of specimen, according to the density of the specimen, it will diffract lights in different ways. So some of the beams will diffract it and getting inwards of this direction, and those beams are collected by this objective. So objective can collect those beams which are diffracted by the specimen, and we can observe light from the specimen around this or on this dark background, because in same principle, those lights which are passing surrounding the specimen, passing only by the slide, will be dark. So the field will be dark and the specimen only can be seen in bright color. So that's why it will add a huge contrast to our specimen. So for this purpose, we do not need to stain our specimen. So we can see a specimen without being stained, and we can watch the specimen especially this kind of microscopy is used to see the extension of a cell, for example pili and flagella, to observe those. For a small protozoas, from water protozoas, we need to see the flagella and the movement of them. We can see using this dark field microscopy. Even we can see this we can use this dark field microscopy to observe live bacterial motion, and can observe the live protozoal motion. Actually, we can observe those flagella really fast, because as they are very very thinner structure, in bright field microscopy too much light will hamper the contrast to observe them. But this dark field microscopy provides the platform to observe those kind of structures. That's why we can use dark field microscopy in those purposes.